professor, we're just not cool with it. Our commitment as Muslims to ourselves first, and then to Canada, and then to the rest of the world, is if someone from amongst us commits an act of oppression, they extend their hand to harm someone, to take someone's life, to damage the property of someone, we are here to do everything in our power to stop them, to denounce them, and to make sure that they are in no way ever associated with us. And your coming here tells me that you are ready to do exactly the same. My brothers and sisters, my dear friends, there are a lot of things spinning out of control around the world. But for us, this is home. This is where we've lived. This is where we're going to live. This is where our kids are growing up. We cannot at any cost allow Canada to spin out of control. We cannot and will not allow the actions of a few people to split us all apart, to pit us against each other, to make us start hating each other, to make us start looking down at each other. We're not going to let that happen. And my last request to all of you. If you have something that you need to learn about any subject, you know that you need to go to the source. We send our kids to schools so they can get properly educated about those subjects that they need to learn about. And we have experts called teachers that we turn our kids to educate them and train them. This is necessary for every subject. And Islam today is a subject of great controversy. It's become one of those words that some people, they just don't know how to look at that word, how to look at the word Muslim. And to be perfectly fair, I have my sisters who wear hijabs that today sometimes feel really scared just to go to school. I have my brothers who might be dressed in Islamic dress, or they have an Islamic looking appearance, and they're wondering what's going to happen to them on the way to work. I have people who are applying for jobs wondering if they're going to be rejected just because they have a Muslim sounding name. These are realities. But my request to all of you is, if and when there is something you want to know about Islam, if there is something you're confused about, frustrated about, something you're hearing in the news, then go to the source. We do not learn about any subject, any civilization, anything important by just following the media and the news. We go to places where there are people who have that knowledge, who can educate us. And I strongly, strongly feel, just like one of the presenters said, man is enemy of that which he knows not. Sunday was a manifestation of somebody becoming an enemy of that which he knew not. But he didn't have to stay like that. That same mosque that he came in and took lives in, he could have just gone there and asked some questions. And the people there would have been more than happy to help him with those questions. Just like that, today we're here. We've always been here. And we're going to stay here. We are here to answer your questions. If you're confused about something, reach out to a Muslim. You'll find them as your neighbors, as your colleagues, your schoolmates. You'll find them traveling on the public transit with you. You'll find them in mosques and schools. You'll find them all around. Go to the source. Ask the questions. Engage. And you'll find that Islam and Muslims are not all that frightening as they're made out to be sometimes. That's what we are about. We are about education. Islam Unraveled is just to educate people, to give them a chance to ask the questions. Many, many people outside, they say, well, we have questions, we don't know who to go to. Well, this is one word, this is one group that started with the intention of just satisfying people's curiosity, answering their questions, giving them a chance to ask the questions and get the answers. So IslamUnraveled.ca, it's on Facebook. If you have a group of friends that have questions and they want someone to come and do a presentation, a little talk, or something very informal, or something very, very formal, look us up. We are ready to engage as long as you are ready to listen. Thank you very much.
Canadian Association to say a few words.
Assalamu alaikum. Peace be unto you. Peace be unto us all. It's snowing, it's cold, but our hearts are warm. The flame behind us, we feel the heat, we feel the warmth, we see the light. But I see light on each and every one of you. We call it Noor. I see the Noor of the beneficent and the merciful and the creator of us all upon all of us here tonight. And it's a beautiful thing to see. But last week, we all received this horrible news, and it took us back. It shocked us, and we really didn't know what to do. I had attended an event celebrating 50 years of the BC Muslim Association that was born from the Al Jamia Masjid. And hours after that event, as I had wandered home and I had taken off my shoes and I was going to settle into my chair and just think about what happened, I got a call from my nephew Abu Bakr Khan, who's one of the organizers here tonight. And he said, Uncle Mun, we've got 30 people in front of the mosque and they're holding candles. So I just got ready. I got out, I got in my car and I drove straight to the mosque. And there they were, 30 people. 30 people holding candles and just standing in front of the mosque because they were compelled to get there. And I asked my nephew, how'd they get here? Well, there were two white kids on Facebook and they sent a note out that we should all do something. And people did. My dear, respected brothers and sisters, the next night, several hundred people, 800 people, came in front of the Vancouver Masjid, and we invited them all in, just as we invited those 30 people in. Tonight, over 1,000 people were in front of the Al Jamia Masjid tonight. And you know what? We invited them all in. And this is what we have to do. This is what we've got to do. We've got to do it in our mosques, in our synagogues, in our churches, in our temples, in our mandirs, in our community centers, any place which we gather. And I'd like to thank the City of Vancouver, the Province of BC, the Vancouver Police Department, the Vancouver Convention Center. Look at this thing. Look at this thing. We're lighting for life. We're lighting to celebrate life. That's the most valuable thing we've got. But in the end, every soul must taste death. It's going to happen to each and every one of us. All of us. We're all going to taste it. But that taste is bitter. That taste is bitter. And for those 17 orphans and the wives who've lost their husbands, I know their pain. I am the son of a father who was murdered. My father, Riyasat Ali Khan, was murdered 14 years ago on a cold day in January. And not a day goes by that I wish he would come in the door, that he would hug me, that he would hold me and say, son, I'm here for you. I'm a father now. I've got 4 children. And I'm blessed with that. And let us be for those children and for those who have lost. Be for them in whatever way we can for them, what their fathers were for them. My dear respected brothers and sisters, our beautiful children and our youth, look at what we got in this beautiful city. Look at what we got. Look around you. We will speak up against hate. We will destroy. We will obliterate ignorance and hate. with peace and understanding. It's doable. We can do it. You know, I had seen a film, and my brother, my younger brother, Austin, we really love films, and there was a movie called Unforgiven, and the outlaw William Money said, it's a hell of a thing to kill a man. You take away everything he's got and everything he will be. And I thought to myself, that's a pretty badass quote. That's pretty cold-blooded shit. But you know what? It's not true. It's not true. Even though you may gun a person down, they may die. Whoever they are matters. Their lives will always matter. They will always be a father. They will always be a brother. They will always be an uncle. They will always be a husband. They will always be a son. And let us be sons and daughters and brothers and sisters to each other. Now, I talked about my younger brother, Asif. Last year, and again, everyone dies. My younger brother died from cancer, leaving behind children. And at his memorial, my nephew, Shahzad Khan, 33 years old, he stood in front of the microphone, remembering his uncle, and he said, you know, my uncle, he always taught me to do the right thing. Do the right thing. Guys, we're doing the right thing. We're doing the right thing. But here's the thing. Now here's my nephew. Young guy. Woke up. Got ready. After Eid. After a prayer. Very major prayer for our community. And he dropped. And he was gone. Pulmonary embolism. Nothing. No idea. Everybody dies. But who really lives? And so this is what we have to do. We have to live for each other. We have to be for each other. What we need. What we need. And what God gives us. And so we've got that here tonight. So ladies and gentlemen, it's snowing, but our hearts are truly warm. God bless each and every one of you. God bless every single one. Thank you.
See, in December, me and a group of my friends, Jewish kids, Christian kids, Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, we all got together, and the weather was horrible. It was just like this right now. It was just like this. And we went and we're like, what can we do? Right? Everywhere I go, I'm berated on my social media with negative stuff. You know what? The world is going to end. Oh my God, we're all going to, Trump is what he won. All this stuff. And this, for me, I was like, what can we do? And so what we did was, we're like, you know what, let's try and help the people in our own community. We opened up the mosque as a shelter for a week. We got food from a gurdwara, come into the mosque, and we distributed it outside of a church. And for me, that was powerful. Because it showed that, you know what, at the end of the day, we're just human beings. And we let people in. There was a guy that stayed at the mosque with us. And he said something to me that it really resonated with me, and it led to the creation of an event like this. He said, we're very multicultural in Canada, right? We're multicultural. We always say it, we're multicultural. But what we really do is tolerate each other. And I said, tolerate each other? What do you mean, man? And it got me thinking. It's time for us to accept and embrace one another. There's something that stuck with me for a while. There's three levels of love. Now the first level of love is that physical love. And that's what's predominant in the society that we live in right now. The second level of love is that emotional, intellectual love. You know what? That love of possession. And that third level of love, it's called lovingness. Loving everyone, loving everything. And for me, I think that's what we gotta get to, is loving everyone. Loving everything that there is. Because that's the only thing that's going to beat hate and fear. See, for me, when the mosque shooting occurred, I thought about it. And once I got the information, you know what? It hit me. I was like, this kid was 27 years old. And I was like, what led this guy, 27-year-old guy, to go to a mosque and kill six people? What led him to that? Right? I was like, he must have just been surrounded by hate, which is the usual in the world we live in now. Hate sells in the media, right? Love doesn't, no one likes to think about love in the media, unfortunately. And so someone like that, he just kept thinking, you know what, these people must be evil. And it reminds me of a story. There was a man that jumped off the Brooklyn Bridge. He committed suicide. And the police went to his apartment miles away. And they found a suicide note. And the suicide note said, you know what, I'm gonna walk from here to the Brooklyn Bridge. And if even one person smiles at me, I won't jump. That's powerful. When was the last time we smiled at each other? I mean, I see so many beautiful people here. Why can't we always be like this? Right? I love you too. I love all of you. No, I mean it. Right? I would love, honestly, if everyone could just give someone a hug right now, please. Give them a hug. It's cold. I mean, it's very cold. Do not let those people that passed away die in vain. Right? The one thing that we can all do is start loving each other. That's the secret. Everyone can talk about Trump, or they can talk about all over the world, but at the end of the day, all we can really do is control ourselves. Why can't we start loving one another? That's the thing I always ask myself. I was like, man, life is so short. I don't want to hate nobody. I mean, that's why I hang out, man. If you want to be loved, you got to start loving people, right? That was the purpose of tonight. Was, you know what? We're 99.9% identical genetically. 99%. This blew my mind. I was like, what? I'm 6'7". I have size 15 feet. This doesn't make sense. But we're 99.9% identical genetically. Whether you're a person in the crowd, you're a person at home, you're a person that's a politician, a waiter at Cactus Club, anything, you're still 99.9% genetical, identical genetically to me. And that means that every single person here has a heart. Every single person here has a heart. And just like we opened up that mosque, and just like there was a mosque in Quebec, we have to keep them open. We got to open up our hearts, because that's what's going to help us. We have bigger problems. The way I look at it is this. If we don't come together now, at a time where it's needed more than ever, where we have problems like global warming that doesn't exist in the United States. Right? We have to come together, because at the end of the day, if we buy a house or we buy a car and all that, what's the point if there's no earth to actually have it on? Woo-hoo! Right? So for me, the point of the event today was this, to stand in solidarity with the six brothers that passed away. But also, it was time for all of us to speak. From different backgrounds, religions, ethnicities, we're all human beings. Every single person here is a human being. And that's why for me, I love all of you, and I mean it. Thank you all for coming. Today was not an easy day, but it really means a lot to all of us. And I know that those six brothers are looking above us, because from an Islamic point of view, they got a first class ticket to heaven. They got a first class ticket. So thank you all again.
Islamic teachings say that when you make a prayer, you should pray with the conviction that it's going to be accepted, that it is accepted. So let's put some faith into this. Let's put some conviction into it, knowing that these prayers will be answered. They will not go in vain. Allahumma anta salam wa minka salam tabarakta ya dal jalali wal ikram. حينا ربنا بالسلام وادخلنا دار السلام. Oh Allah, you are peace, and from you comes peace. Keep us alive with peace, and enter us into the abode of peace, and unite our hearts with peace, and remove from our hearts hatred and animosity, remove from our hearts divisions, remove from our hearts anxieties towards one another, unite our hearts in the brotherhood of humanity and ease for us all our affairs and remove for us all barriers and remove from us all obstacles that hinder us in becoming those people that you love and make us from amongst those that you shower your favors upon and do not make us amongst those who draw your anger and do not make us amongst those who go astray and do not make us amongst those who cause trouble to others and make us amongst those who become a source of love and ease and comfort for all of mankind. Ameen.
Thank you, Mufti Asim, for that beautiful dua. As we come to a close, I would like to thank each and every one of you for taking the time out of your evening to stand here in solidarity with us tonight. I would also like to thank the following organizations for their support of this evening's rally: the NCCM, the National Council of Canadian Muslims, the Islamophobia Legal Assistance Hotline in BC, Vancouver Medina, Nisa Homes, Coalition Against Bigotry Pacific, Islam Unraveled, Sikhi Awareness Foundation Canada, the Federation of Asian Canadian Lawyers, Voices of Muslim Women Program, North Shore Unitarian Church, I'm sure you heard them singing at the beginning, they were beautiful, the Philippine Women's Center of BC, International Socialists Vancouver, BC Humanists Association, and my pages are sticking together. Donnacella Promotions, West 8th Jamia Masjid, Lower Mainland Sikh Gurdwaras, and Decibel Entertainment, who are providing our sound systems tonight. And as we leave the rally tonight, we need to realize that this is only the beginning of many, many days, months, years of hard work and commitment. We must continue to call out the systems of oppression that have perpetuated Islamophobia. We must realize that white supremacist tendencies are often veiled by our Canadian myth of multiculturalism. We must continue to voice our dissatisfaction with groups and individuals who are pushing agendas of fear and hatred. This is a time for us to be vigilant, to speak out when we hear strangers, friends, colleagues, and sometimes even family members using and repeating Islamophobic and discriminatory rhetoric. Today, let us commit to speak out for those whose voices may not be as loud and to intervene any time we encounter or witness oppression and injustice. And finally, once again, I'd like to thank you all for coming out tonight in this amazing weather. I hope you all make it home safely tonight. Have a great evening. Sorry, just a couple of last things that I forgot to mention. As I did mention that this is only the beginning, I'd like to thank all of you for coming out here tonight. And next weekend, there's going to be a march and a rally at the Peace Arch Park. It was actually scheduled for tomorrow, but due to the weather, it's been canceled. It's the No Ban, No Wall Vancouver. And join them tomorrow, next Sunday, February 12th. Also, there's an initiative that's being held in association with the Canadian Blood Services to donate blood. It's called hashtag Muslim Blood Drive, which is being donated in the memory of the Quebec mosque attack victims. And anyone is able to just go to the Oak Street Clinic in Vancouver, as well as the Guildford Clinic in Surrey, that are accepting blood donors in memory of this tragic event. Thank you all.
Oh, do you want me to flip it? Fail.